Polaventris presents Commodore 64 game called Parade Over Moscow. This game was requested by Bandit032X.
This is Raid Over Moscow on Commodore 64, a game requested by Bandit032X. Let's give it a go. Go with the beginner. It's been a while since I played this one. I did like it back in the day. It was awesome. So, launch detected. I'm sure that's a packet of goodwill. And your job is to save the world as we know it. Come on. There we go. We're in the space station with our space airplanes and our mission is to save the world from package of goodwill. There we go. Your first problem is to get out of this place. It is one of the function keys that open the doors. Come on. What is it? 7, 6, 5. I think I had to have enough altitude before the door opens. Come on, yes, the radio is F7, I think. And that's F5. Oh crap! I can do this without issues, but it's been a while. That's my excuse. I stick with it. And that is the official way to enter a space airplane. Teleport in with your own. Okay, F5. F7. That seems to do the trick. Now, out of the door. And on the small line. Going down to the Minsk launch site. Atlanta, hope you're watching how I saved your ass. Down I go, down I go, down I go, down I go. And we go. Now we're at the ground level. Oh, the crap, that was close. Oh, crap. Man, I suck. Usually I'm not that bad at this game, but I thought that already, didn't I? Oh well, now I suck. I did like this game back in the day a lot because it has a lot of different stages. But this trying to get out of the space station stage, flying down to the Earth stage. Then you have that, I guess it's F7 stage where you scroll right. And then you have a stage, well, I shouldn't spoil it because it's pretty awesome. And even after that, you have one more stage, which I don't think I never completed back in the day. But let's try to get through this ground attack phase or whatever. Push forward to fly close to ground. Pull back to go up. Don't go too high because the missile will get you. Unless you want to go up and shoot the missile. Damn your trucks. Hate those trucks. I don't know why, but just have to hate the trucks. Get rid of the helicopter. And there we go. Not too difficult. And then, there was this stage too. I forgot about this one. I don't think you have to destroy all of the pylons. Just the middle one. The ship turns blue when you're in right height. Shoot it. Let's try to find the right height. Come on. Get rid of him before we get other radar. There we go. Boom! And Atlanta is safe. Next. The last one is Moscow, and the mission is to attack the Red Square with bazooka. As fancy as it sounds like, that's what you have to do. Get some height, F7 to open the door, and then just zoom out. Land your space airplane from the space station, because obviously that's where you keep your airplanes. Say hello to the package of goodwill. And visit the beautiful city of Saratov. Oh, did I get two targets with one bullet? This stage always stays the same. So if you know what to do, it's not too difficult at all. But still, I managed to fail it the first time, so I shouldn't say anything about that. As I obviously suck! Get the helicopter, land down so don't get hit by the missile, and destroy the launch site middle tower again. You can shoot the other ones, but it's no really point. Other than points, of course. The point is the points. Get the highest points, go down. And all, you don't see the blue bit if you are not lined up correctly. So you have to line up and then adjust your height. Oh, that was close. I think you are in the right height. Yep, there you go. Kaboom! Next one. Next site, from Leningrad to Chicago, space, goodwill, interceptor fighter planes, our goal. Turn around, kill the momentum, get some height, open the doors, and zoom out. It is pretty awesome. And I think it had quite a lot of fuzz back in the day. As they still had the Cold War going on. But I'm sure that was on purpose. I'm sure it did a lot of good for the number of sales. I have to be quick, otherwise a tank will easily kill you. Get up, get rid of the missile, get the helicopter, go down, and get rid of the last launch site before the Moscow. Oh, I'm at the right height already, so there you go. Boom! Approaching Moscow. This one was a little bit different, but still shouldn't be anything too difficult. Looks almost the same as the ones before. Maybe it is the same. Might make a different stage for this. You can just use the old one. Wait for the missile. Up, get rid of that, delete the helicopter, go down to avoid the missile, and Moscow, here we are. I usually could get into this Moscow stage quite easily, but the one after that is the trouble one. This one you just push forward to shoot lower trajectory, and there are a few parts of the building you have to destroy, and at the same time try to avoid the sniper fire, the tank. I think you have to shoot the doors at least. Don't stay in one place too long, otherwise the tank will get you. For some, it does remind me of games like Beachhead. Get rid of the tank. Also, you can shoot the guys. Stay in movement so you don't get shot so easily. Another place you have to destroy is the towers. A little bit higher. There you go. Another one. Smack. Down or down. After this you still have one stage where you fight the evil Soviet Central Computer in a Tron flying disc match. It's probably the most difficult part of the game. I've only completed it once in during a live stream with an infinite lives cheat. Trying to remember what else I did. I had to. Can I shoot those ones? I can shoot the guys. That's obvious. But I'm thinking about that. That one. Obviously not. How about these ones? Oh, yes. Oh, crap! Got me. Luckily, you don't have to go through the flying bits if you get killed here. Oh, damn, that was close. Did you go right to exit the note? Can't remember. Oh, yes, you can destroy those two. Just have to hit them. I think it should take you to the last stage automatically. Oh, yes, you can destroy those two. Don't stay in one place. See if I can go. No. Like I said, should take you automatically there. Maybe you can destroy that one. Oh, that went through. Didn't even collide with anything. Maybe you shoot the middle door again. Can't remember. Ooh, that was close. About shooting the guys. Maybe you can't proceed without shooting the people. Oh, that was the tank. That was good. Or maybe it's just timed. You have to survive for a certain time and cause enough destruction to access the talk and play again. Oh, nice animation with the dying guy. There's no Nothing in the middle to shoot? No. Oh, smack. Looks like the guy from the city quest is also makes an appearance in this game. Come on, get it. You can do it. Do it. Yes, this is the last stage, and this is the evil Soviet central computer's thingy. Throw the disc, and you have to hit the thingy from the back. Which is not easy. If it hits the front like that, it's useless. You can adjust the angle of the attack. By up and down, you can see where the thing will hit in the wall. And the bot, robot in the middle, also follows a certain route, so you can learn the right places where you do an attack from the behind. And of course, you got a limited amount of discs. Not an easy task to do. I think you have to hit him something like 3 times from the behind. With limited amount of discs, that is not easy. That was close, but no cigar. Try to get him in the middle. Ooh! Yay! Pretty good luck to get it so early in the game. And to go back, you need to destroy the Kreml again. So I think that's enough. The video is getting way too long anyway. So this is Raid Over Moscow on Commodore 64. Awesome game. Go and play it yourself. Thanks for watching. And thanks for the requests. Shoot me. Come on. There we go. Bleh.